This is underneath the artificial light, and it has to have my laptop behind it. See, my laptop's behind it, running through it. Isn't it mad, the colour on that? Isn't that crazy? My finger. That's my finger. Isn't that crack as that? Isn't that crack as that? Both pieces are exactly the same as well. It's the only vinyl set I have where both pieces are the same in regards to the colouring. Normally one is offset with a different colour to the other. Isn't that just the most bizarre? See, there's my finger again behind it. I love this CD. And I love this movie. This is the third Burton, isn't it? Yeah, I was early teens when the first Batman was out. First Burton Batman was out. And I was never really one for movies when I was younger. It was only recently, in latter years, so to speak, in later years, and now these years, that I'm into movies. I was more into music back when the first of Burton's Batman movies were out. That's why I didn't really notice Burton's first Batman. I was heavily into my music and going out on the club scene and things. I used to work in nightclubs. I used to work in nightclubs full time, things like that. Around the time of Burton's first Batman movie, so you know, movies and things just passed me on by. It was only when this Batman movie came out that I had sort of like finished doing the nightclub circuit, the night working the nightclub scenes. It was only when this movie started to come out around about now-ish, after I'd done the nightclubs for a few years, that I started to pay attention more to movies as I was growing up more, as I was getting older in years, early 20s, that I started to then start to pay more attention to movies, and that's when this movie sort of like dropped, and I got really into this one. Because I do naturally have a flamboyant nature. And I took to it. I thought it was great at the time. You've got to remember, my movies are made to serve purpose. Simple as, the movies are made to make money. To serve purpose. So, that's why movies are a good way of looking back. This has reminded me of that TV series Gotham and Watch. Over an hour long, I think. I'm about 20 minutes into it. Gordon has just took the virus and he's just broke out of the coffin. That's where I'm up to. And he's just returned to the police station and he still has the virus in him. He's just managed to establish some sort of relationship with his fellow kinsman at the virus in him. Strangely enough, they've managed to be able to write that into the narrative. I thought he would have to go alone once he'd injected the virus in him. But no, strange enough, how they managed to write, as I say, how they'd done it, only a TV series could write it in.